I noticed three small notches around the edge of the stump's top. The tripod's feet fitted neatly into the notches on the top of the stump. The light, falling from above, struck the gem and scattered in five neat rays.
And each ray picked out a letter. Starting from the left, I could read,
M-A-R-I-B. Marib. Now all I had to do was figure out what the heck that meant.
Nico, I've seen them.
Who?
The Templars. I spied on their meeting in the catacombs.
And you saw the Knights Templar?
I saw a bunch of guys masquerading as Templars. They're after something called the Sword of Baphomet. The bogus doctor was there, the guy who killed Marquet. The manuscript is the key, just as we thought. It shows the way to the Broken Sword, whatever that is.
And how does the assassin fit into all this?
He's out to stop them. These Neo-Templars, they're men and women in influential positions. Don't you see? Plantar was one of them. The assassin killed him for the manuscript, to stop them finding the sword.
But now we have got the manuscript.
Yes.
So, how do they hope to find the sword?
I don't know. They said something about a lens and a guy called Klausner who's gone to Syria. But they didn't seem to realize the significance of the very site of their meeting. You see, after they'd gone, I discovered a stone pedestal and a carved inscription. I set up the gem on the tripod, directly below a beam of light. The gem split the beam and lit the letters M-A-R-I-B.
Marib is a village in Syria.
Then the Neo-Templars are ahead of us. Klausner beat me to it.
You're not thinking of going there yourself, are you?
Why not?
These guys are crazy and dangerous. That reminds me, you should leave the gem here.
Okay. What about the tripod?
I'll send it back to André, anonymously.
Do you think I should go to Marib?
Syria is a long way, Georges.
Hey there, young fella. Speak you the English? Speak you the Anglais? Parlez-vous Anglais?
Yes, si, and indeed, oui. And rather better than you by the sound of it. My name is Nicho. Welcome to my grand emporium of quality merchandise.
So, this is your stand?
Oh, yes, sir. Though, stand does not begin to do it justice. The finest in this bustling metropolis.
This is a bustling metropolis?
Well, not per se, no.
How much are those books there on the shelf?
Have you any Syrian pounds?
I think I might have a couple of Irish pund.
Then they're too expensive for you, sir.
You speak very good English.
Thank you, sir. I learned from tapes that my uncle procured.
Oh, a language course.
No, sir. Jeeves and Wooster. Gussie, Fink, Nottle. Aunt Agatha. Watho.
Does the word Templar mean anything to you?
Templar. Ah, Templar. Huh? Templar. Why, yes, of course.
It does?
Yes. A splendid series of books by Mr. Leslie Charteris. Featuring the roguish Mr. Simon Templar.
Great. That's a real help, Nijo. Anything else?
The Saint television program featuring Mr. Roger Moore of the quizzical eyebrow. And a stick man with a halo. Bing!
So all Templar means to you is Roger Moore.
I only watched it for the stick man with the halo. Bing! He was better animated.
So, I'm correct in saying that the word Templar doesn't mean much to you.
Well, there was the Order of Knights who were wiped out in an Inquisition in 1312, I suppose.
That's them. What else do you know?
Just how much information do you think there is on a Trivial Pursuit card?
A what?
From the medieval edition. We had it on this stand a couple of years ago. Ask me what a futer is. Go on. I know all this stuff.
Never mind. Okay, forget about the Templars for a minute. What do you know about knights?
Like the Crusaders, they came to the East on an insane and pointless mission. They sacrificed thousands of lives, including their own, for insensate pride. How anyone can find them romantic confounds me.
So long, Nijo.
Toodle pip, sir.
Hi, I was wondering whether you could help me.
Why, sure, son. Always got time for a fellow American. The name's Henderson. Dwayne Henderson.
Pleased to meet you, Mr. Henderson.
Hell, boy. I'm not in the office. Call me Dwayne.
Oh, okay. Dwayne? My name's George Stobart. I saw a medieval picture of a woman. Royalty or nobility, something like that. She was looking in a mirror, but the reflection was of a man with three faces. What do you think of that?
I think you should be in therapy.
Do you think bulls have any significance around here?
Weird question, George. Nope, I don't think they have.
Do you mind if I ask you an odd question?
Okay, but I might not answer it.
Do you know anything about the Templars?
The Knights Templar?
Yep.
Nope. Nothing at all.
Well, you knew they were an order of knights.
What I know and what I say are two different things, boy. I haven't lasted as long as I have in this business without knowing that.
In this business?
Sure. The greetings card business.
Oh, please. Does the image of a knight holding a crystal ball mean anything to you?
Hell no. What would a knight want with a hunk of glass?
I don't know. That's the prob...
What's wrong, boy?
It's not a crystal ball. It all came together in my head. What the conspirators had mentioned losing. The strange perspective of the manuscript. It's a lens! Have you talked to Nijo?
Nijo? He's the youngster on that junk stand, right? Yeah, we've met him. He's a smart kid. Speaks four languages, and he's never had a day's formal education. He should go far. Kept trying to peddle garbage on us, though.
You're not gonna find much worthwhile around here.
I know that, and you know that. But try telling Pearl. She reckons there's antiquities in them door stands.
You're a long way from home, Dwayne.
Could say the same about you, George.
Me? Well, I'm just sightseeing, that's all.
Without a camera? Kinda lags to come all this way, not take pictures. Mind if I take a picture of you, George?
What? Why?
Ow!
You could've warned me.
You don't mind, do you, George? The folks back home will be real interested.
What exactly do you do, Dwayne?
Didn't I say? Oh, I run a greeting card company. Yep. We're based in Cleveland, Ohio. Pearl writes the poems for her. You ought to ask her to recite some.
Where is your wife, Dwayne?
Pearl? Oh, she's around, looking for bargains.
How long have you been married, Dwayne?
Hell, must be, 30 years now.
Okay, well, I'll see you around, Dwayne.
Count on it, George.
Hello. I was wondering whether you could help me.
Why, hi there, handsome. What can I do for you?
Hi, my name's George. I was just...
Well, it certainly is delightful to meet you, George.
I was...
My name's Mrs. Henderson, but you can call me Pearl, I'm sure.
Okay, Pearl. I was...
So nice to meet a friendly American face so far from home.
Pearl?
Yes, dear?
I was just wondering if you could help me.
Why, sure, precious.
Have you ever heard of a group of knights called the Templars?
Sounds familiar. I remember. Dwayne had a book. The Holy Something and the Holy Something Else, I can't quite recall. I read a little of it.
And?
Seemed like a lot of hooey to me.